From Vin Baker living as a pastor to Allen Iverson becoming a mental health advocate, it's amazing seeing where these players have ended up. Here are a few NBA players that have retired and where they've ended up, starting with none other than the great Shaquille O'Neal. Shaq was a dominant force on the court, and after retiring in 2011, he transitioned into a successful media career as an analyst on TNT's Inside the NBA. He's also been involved in various business ventures and even dabbled in acting. I think it's safe to say that he's a man of many talents. What about Allen Iverson? Known for his flashy style and incredible ball handling skills, Iverson retired in 2011. Since then, he's been involved in various endeavors, including coaching, music, and fashion. He's also been very vocal about his struggles with mental health and has become an advocate for mental health awareness. Another player who retired and went on to have a successful media career is Grant Hill. After retiring in 2013, Hill became an analyst on NBA TV and has also been involved in various business ventures, including becoming a part owner of the Atlanta Hawks. Wow, he really made it big, huh? Let's not forget about Tim Duncan, one of the best power forwards of all time. After retiring in 2016, he's been enjoying his time off the court, spending time with his family, and even opening up a car customization shop in his hometown of San Antonio. He sure decided to take life easy. Moving on, we have Vin Baker, who was an incredible player during his time in the NBA. He played for teams like the Milwaukee Bucks, Seattle Supersonics, and Boston Celtics, and was a four-time NBA All-Star. But after struggling with alcoholism, he eventually retired from the game in 2006. So what has Vin been up to since retiring from the NBA? Well, after getting sober and turning his life around, he went back to school and earned a degree in theology. He then became an ordained minister and started preaching at his church in Connecticut. But that's not all. Vin also got back into the game of basketball in a different way. He started working as an assistant coach for the Milwaukee Bucks, where he helped develop young players and shared his knowledge and experience with the team. Guess you can't stay away from the game for long. Next on the list is one of the greatest point guards of all time, Magic Johnson. After retiring in 1996, Magic has been involved in various business ventures, including owning multiple Starbucks locations and a stake in the Los Angeles Dodgers. He's also been involved in philanthropy, including creating the Magic Johnson Foundation, which focuses on HIV/AIDS prevention and education. The next one is not as well known as Johnson, Steve Francis. The former Rockets and Magic's point guard was a fan favorite during his time in the league. Since retiring in 2010, Steve has been relatively low-key, but he's still involved in the basketball world. He's participated in charity games and youth basketball camps, showing that he still has a passion for the game. Another player who couldn't leave the game is Adrian Dantley. Our star played for several teams during his career, including the Detroit Pistons and Utah Jazz. After retiring in 1991, Adrian went on to become a high school basketball coach, leading his teams to several state championships. He's also been involved in politics, serving as a city councilman in his hometown of Washington, D.C. Pretty impressive. Now we have Bryant Reeves, who played for the Vancouver Grizzlies from 1995 to 2001. After retiring due to injuries, Reeves returned to his hometown in Arkansas and became a cattle farmer. That's right, you heard it here first. Big Country is now a farmer. He owns and operates a ranch that specializes in breeding and selling cattle. It's always great to see former players pursuing their passions outside of basketball, and it seems like Bryant has found his calling in farming. Now, Sean Kemp decided he wanted to do something inspiring after retirement, and that's what he did. Kemp played for several teams during his career, including the Supersonics and Cavaliers. After retiring in 2003, Kemp struggled with addiction and legal troubles, but he's since turned his life around. He's been involved in various business ventures, including owning a cannabis dispensary in Seattle. He's also been an advocate for cannabis use in professional sports and has been open about his own struggles with addiction.
You know, I came out here to support my boy. I'm about to hand this to him, man. He about to open up this.
It's a huge responsibility, so I had to really think about this before I put my name on this project.
Moving on, we have Mark Blunt, who played for several teams during his career, including the Boston Celtics and the Miami Heat. After retiring in 2010, Blunt became involved in real estate development and founded his own construction company. He's also been an active philanthropist, using his success to give back to his community. Speaking of giving back, Dan Dickow decided that he wanted to make life easier for the newer players, Dick outplayed for several teams during his career, including the New Orleans Hornets and the Boston Celtics. After retiring in 2011, Dick Al became a basketball analyst and commentator for various media outlets, including ESPN and Fox Sports.
Being a part of this program, it's teammates, it's coaches, it's a few of the other special people around the program, guys like talk to a couple other people. But at the end of the day, it comes down to, for me at least, it came down to certain people. You know, he called to congratulate me. I think that's at the moment I was like, okay, well, some of these notes work and some don't.
He's also been involved in coaching and player development, working with young athletes to help them reach their full potential. It was really inspiring to see him sharing their knowledge and experience with the next generation of athletes. Moving on, we have LaRue Martin, who was the first overall pick in the 1972 NBA draft by the Portland Trail Blazers. Although he only played four seasons in the league, Martin made a lasting impact on the game. After retiring, he became a successful businessman and is now the CEO of his own marketing and advertising agency. He's also been involved in various philanthropic ventures, using his success to give back to his community. Now, the next player on the list is someone who also wanted to help younger athletes, but this time physically. I'm talking about Karl Malone, who played for the Utah Jazz and the Los Angeles Lakers during his career. After retiring in 2004, Malone has stayed involved in the basketball world, working as a coach and mentor for young players. He's also been involved in various business ventures, including owning several car dealerships in Louisiana. Plus, he's been a vocal advocate for physical fitness and has even created his own fitness program, the Karl Malone Power Train. If you've ever heard of it, then you know how much of an impact it has. Charlie Ward is another player who wanted to leave an impact on the league and the world. Ward played for the New York Knicks and the Houston Rockets during his career. After retiring in 2005, Ward turned his attention to coaching, serving as an assistant coach for the Houston Rockets and the Orlando Magic. He's also been involved in various philanthropic ventures, using his platform to give back to his community. He's even become a motivational speaker and has even published a book. Next on the list is Vinny Johnson, who played for the Detroit Pistons and the San Antonio Spurs during his career. After retiring in 1992, Johnson went on to become a successful businessman, founding the Piston Group, a company that provides automotive products and services. He's also been involved in various philanthropic ventures, including supporting education initiatives in Detroit. A league player focusing on education isn't something common and is a change that we'd love to see. Last but not least, I have Michael Jordan, widely considered the greatest basketball player of all time. Jordan retired multiple times throughout his career and most recently retired from the game for good in 2003. Since then, he's been involved in various business ventures, including owning the Charlotte Hornets and launching his own brand, Jordan Brand, which has become one of the most successful athletic brands in the world. And that's it for all the NBA players for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.